Perfect. Plus,
if he just drank something, Hank, were you just drinking? Like, did you just have a drink?
He's always drinking.
I was having sex with my mother.
Because if he just had a drink right now, the reading's going to be a lot higher than it would normally.
All right, let's see what it is.
Okay, ready?
Give me the reading.
Take a deep breath and blow into it. Keep going. All right, let's see what's coming up.
What do you think, Mom? What do you think?
It's going up. No, you're good. I don't need it anymore.
He's blowing into it again.
Yeah, I'm blowing.
No, don't blow.
Don't blow.
It's still going up.
I was hoping to have sex.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, you're going to have sex. Don't worry.
He's just got sex on the brain. Yeah.
All right, it stopped at a 0.379.
Okay, 379,
that sounds awful, too.
That's awful, but not as high as a 5.
Right.
At least he's not dead.
0.379?
Yep. It's going down. I would say it probably was about a 0.375.
Right. Wow. I mean, by the way, that's nothing to sneeze at.
No.
What did you say the legal drunk age, the drunk limit?
0.1.
He's at a 0.375. Is that the highest reading you've ever seen?
Yes, that's the highest reading I've ever seen.
That's the highest reading you ever saw.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
Remember when Fred passed out? What were you, Fred?
I think it was 2 point something.
It was 0.2
and
something.
I couldn't even stand up.
Right. Yeah,
I don't know how he's doing it.
Howard, my friend's a cop.
Three times his size.
My friend's a cop. He says, like, 0.10 is, you know, illegal. 0.15 is drunks. And 0.20 and up are the people you see staggering into walls.
Right.
And Hank is functioning.
But Hank has developed a tolerance.
Hank, you're pretty amazing.
I don't get it.
I bet you Hank is never below
I'm amazing.
A 0.1.
He's the world's greatest drunk.
Let's do some of those tests on Hank.
What, IQ?
Yeah, can he do what? What is it you're supposed to do? Count backwards from 10 or...
Oh, okay. 100? Oh, I you don't mean IQ. You mean drunk test.
No, drunk test.
All right, what does he got to do, Gary? You know.
Okay, here's a good one, Hank. Hank, put your arms out straight like an airplane. Close your eyes.
Uh-oh. And stand behind him. Stand behind him when he does it, because he's going to pass out. Right.
And with just one hand, just one of those hands, touch your nose. Tilt your head back.
It doesn't matter which one.
No.
Tilt your head back and touch your nose.
He did it.
Okay.
Hey, that's pretty cool.
Count backwards from 100, Hank.
199, 98, 97, 96, 95, 94, 93, 92, 91, 90. 89, 88, 87, 86, 85, 84,
85. You guys got a 0.375.
You
need, no, he doesn't.
And the other one is, put your hand stretched out again. Stretch out again like an airplane, and hop up and down on 1 foot.
No, stand behind.
I can't even do that on a sober.
Okay.
Yeah, all right. He did enough, believe me. I wonder if he could walk
about
a straight line. Yeah. Can you walk? I don't care. He can't. Please.
Yeah, I could.
You could walk a straight line?
He can pass all these tests.
He's pretty amazing drunk.
Let him drive.
Yeah. Hey, Charles, you're on the air.
What happened
to Howard?
To hell with it. I want to hear this guy yell at Hank. Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, tell him that he can go have sex with his mother.
Yeah, Charles, what's up?
Hank, man, I'll beat you bad, man.
Are you a dwarf?
Yeah.
And you're mad at Hank?
No, you're not a dwarf. You're an asshole. I wouldn't have sex with your mother.
Sir, are you a dwarf who
your
works?
Your mother is probably a whore.
But, sir, are you a responsible dwarf?
Yes, I am.
You
he's
are?
No, he's not. He's an asshole.
And what do you do for a living?
Well, me, I don't work.
He has sex with his mother.
All right. Man, that's an old line already.
Can he say that one more time?
Hey, Charles.
Yeah.
So what do you do for a living?
I don't work.
Oh, you don't work?
No.
No, he just jerks off.
All right, Charles, thank you for the call.
All right.
Oh, wait a second. No F-word. No F-word.
Oh, that's
all right.
Good.
It's a funny line, but no F-word. Manny, you're on the air.
Yeah, Hank.
Yeah. Hey, Hank, you might have an issue with your mother.
Let this greenhorn shut the hell up because he doesn't know his ass from his elbow.
He hasn't said anything
back
yet.
Portugal.
This is a different guy. Man, you go back to Portugal. Manny, go ahead.
All people named Manny are from Portugal.
Manny, what can we do for you? You there?
Yeah,
Manny hung up.
I heard Manny hung up.
Manny, are you there? I guess Manny's gone. Stan, you're on the air. Hank, you're acting so much like Hank.
Wow. Well, you got somebody named Hank on then?
If I ever get a TV show, like a sitcom, Hank's on it.
He's your neighbor.
Yeah. Me with Hank the neighbor. I tell you, the thing will be a home run. Stan, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Are we pissing on your lawn?
Stan. Stan, Busmachta, where are you?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's happening?
Yo, the dwarf, why do you drink so much?
Who's he talking to, me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then shut up, you asshole.
Okay. All right, there's Hank. Hank, why don't you get seated because...
Tell him to go have sex with his mother.
All right, listen.
I mean, I already did it.
Don't you imagine that...
Did you have sex with your mother? Ever?
No.
No, he's saying he had sex with that guy's mother.
No, I know that, but I'm just saying, have you ever had sex with your mother?
She was no good anyways. She was a cheap tramp. Go have sex with Jesus Christ, you faggot.
All right, there you go, Hank. Samantha, you're on the air.
Hi, how are you, Howard?
All right.
What's up with the dude and his, little having the sex with your mother?
Well, he has a hang-up with his mother. He says he thinks about having sex with her.
I didn't have sex.
No, he didn't.
I didn't have sex with
her. He says he's looked at his mother and he's been attracted to her.
He's a normal human being. All of you others lie.
What do you mean? I don't want to have sex. You ever look at my mother?
No.
I ain't having sex with that.
Boy.
I never thought about it. Peter, you're on the air.
Hank.
Yeah.
This is Peter. I'm a dwarf, and I think that you are a disgrace to all the dwarfs, and you should not consider yourself a dwarf. You're a midget.
Well, you're an asshole.
No, you're the midget.
So
you're an asshole.
And I've had sex with her.
You've had sex with his mother?
You had sex with your mother, you loser. You're a midget.
Well, go
and
loser.
No, wait. Hank, no F word.
You're a drunk loser. When was the last time you worked? Now, everyone thinks that us dwarfs are disgusting. You're a midget. That's what you are, a midget.
And you're an idiot. You're an imbecile.
Midget.
I know dead people who are smarter than you. All right. I could talk to a retarded cohog and get a better conversation out of one of them. So I could talk to a politician. I could talk to one of those church-going faggots. You stupid weirdo. Go have sex with Jesus Christ, you faggot.
All right, there you go, Hank. Well, you certainly told that guy off.
Wow.
Go have sex with Jesus Christ, you faggot.
It's the first time I've ever heard that one.
All right, I got to take a break, but first, one last guy on the phone. Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
Hey, this bar that hangs out in Fall River?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, he started mouthing off to these, big burly truck driver guys, right? So they picked him up and went dwarf bowling. Slid his ass down the side of the bar and knocked down all the mugs on the thing.
Did some guys start bowling with you, Hank, the other night? Some guys beat your ass?
I caught him up in Africa.
This idiot is a liar.
He is a liar?
Never happened?
Yeah. Oh, shut up, you little bitch. You know it happened.
I didn't. I don't go bowling.
No,
they
use you as a bowling ball.
Go have sex with your mother.
Let me go sex your little ass, you little bitch.
Hank.
Hey.
You're a bitch.
Hank, did someone pick you up and throw you down a bar?
No.
No?
Oh, shit. He's so full of it.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm going to get the waitress on the line if you give me 5 minutes.
All right.
Yeah, right. What are you going to do? You're going to give her $5 to have sex with her or something?
All right. Joe, what is the final word here?
Hey, Hank, is your penis dwarf too?
Huh?
Yeah, just like your brain.
All right, that's the final word from Hank. Hank, you're going to be part of our judging panel this morning.
You like to see beautiful women. This woman says she's prettier than Pamela Lee.
There was a girl coming in here who says she's prettier than Pamela Anderson Lee.
Oh, this is going to be good.
All right, and you're going to be the judge. You're going to tell us. You're going to be honest?
Yeah.
You are. All right. There we go. It's going to be fun when we get back. More hygiene. What are you, a D cup? Wow, look at those. And those are real.
I love those.
You haven't seen the tape?
I haven't seen it, no.
You should watch it. You should read it.
Well,
you guys should sell
copy.
It. You know what you
I
ought
do
to do?
I do not have a copy.
You ought to sell it.
Want to buy one?
Let me sell them for you. Let me sell them for you. I'll make you $50 million. Yes, you'll never have to work again. I swear.
See, you glad to come up here and see Howard again?
I love Howard. He's good. But I have a feeling he's going to trash me today.
Why?
I have a feeling. Oh, there's just a little bit of stuff going on in my life that I'm sure he's going to focus on.
Like what? Tell me why.
Oh, you know, I've heard him. My husband was talking to him a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, Tommy called a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, I know. So Tommy called me last night. He's like, be prepared.
Gary tells me Pamela looks incredible.
It's amazing. She's 8 months pregnant, and she looks incredible.
I didn't even notice. She's 8 months pregnant?
Yes. Wow. That's what I could not believe.
I got to see
well,
this.
I wouldn't even,
does she look great?
She's wearing the cutest little dress today.
Really?
Yeah. Little spaghetti straps, but they're like undone.
It's oh, there's a glow in my pants. Go ahead. Let me see this. I gotta get with her.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
But
Pamela Lee.
I don't know where she's carrying this baby.
Oh, she's so cute. God, I want her so bad. I hate to get all mushy like this, Robin,
that's
but I'm
mushy.
In love. Let me see. Wait, don't walk so fast. You are pregnant?
Yes. Can you believe it?
Oh, what a piece of ass. What a piece of ass you are. Oh, I can't stand you.
I'm pregnant.
What?
I'll take that compliment because I'm pregnant.
I can't even stand you anymore. I'm so horny. You didn't even know she was pregnant, did you?
No. I had no idea.
8.5 months.
Yeah, she's almost
wow.
finished
almost
with
done.
Her pregnancy.
You're glowing. I'm glowing.
Are you glowing?
I glow when you're in the room.
Mm-hmm.
You make me happy.
She's glowing.
So
you're pregnant. He's
here.
Glowing.
You're happy to be here?
I'm happy to be here. I love coming here.
Really?
Yes, even though you abuse me totally, but I, you know.
What?
I really don't.
Actually, you're pretty good when I'm here. It's just when I leave.
Am I really
what
mean to you?
Well,
I don't think you're mean. I think you're just, you know.
Oh, because I play your Playboy tapes?
You do?
Yeah.
I didn't even know that.
The one where you talk about a guy's butt being your favorite part of the man's body? Oh, and I talked
true.
To, I had Tommy on the other day, and I did talk, first of all, I got to say something.
What?
I am totally outraged that that tape of you and Tommy that was stolen from your home.
Yeah.
Is the judge ruled, I read this in the paper today,
yeah.
The judge ruled that it's okay to sell the tape? That's your property.
You know, it's so disgusting. It's just whatever. You know, I hope their mothers are proud, these guys that are selling this.
But I don't know how a judge could rule that.
Well, you know, it's...
By the way, the tape does not make you look bad. I saw the tape. I got to tell you something.
I haven't even seen the tape.
Can I tell you something?
We never watched it.
You never?
We taped
wow.
it. I don't even know what's on.
This is like with, you know, with Tommy's crummy camera. You look incredible.
Right. I bet.
You do. You really do.
Well, gee, thanks. I'm glad you saw it.
And let me tell you something. You know how to please your husband. You really do.
Thank you. I please me.
I want to play it for my wife. But I don't want her to see how big Tommy is.
You know what? All you can play is the audio for you.
I know.
File him out.
Oh, God. I know. I knew this. Well, you know what? It's just disgusting. They're like, whatever.
All right. It was your private moments.
Yeah.
And that's why I like the tape. Your breasts are gorgeous.
My what?
Your breasts.
Thank you.
You really have great breasts.
Those are mother's breasts.
They're mother's breasts.
I don't care
breasts.
What they are. I'd have sex with you even though you're 8 months pregnant. I really would.
It's the best when you're pregnant.
Is it really?
It's
you have sex even now, right now, with Tommy?
Are you kidding? Are you kidding? I haven't seen him. I saw him, like, we were apart for a month, so
right.
He was home for a couple of days, and...
And you gotta miss that.
He can't walk.
There you go. Really? That much? Yeah, these two have sex.
All the time.
All the time.
That is what love is supposed to be like, Howard.
Yeah.
I tell you, I really saw that you are in love. Even though I shouldn't have watched the tape, when I got a hold of it, I said, this is wrong, this is their private moments, no one should watch this.
And that was the 50th time.
Yeah. And but I've watched it, like, 20 times. I have. Yeah. I admit, I have. I'm sorry. I apologize.
I only watched once. I didn't know what I would be looking at.
What did you say about Tommy?
I don't even want to know.
What did you say about Tommy when you saw the tape?
What did I say?
What did you say?
Well, I can't remember.
Oh, I remember.
What did I say?
You fainted. Do you believe how big Tommy is?
I know what I said. The next day I said Tommy was like a woman with large breasts. He could not control it. It was everywhere.
And you guys have the most fun. I told Tommy this.
We have so much fun. We like, have the most fun out of any couple I know.
You do?
I bet.
We're totally in love and happy. And
I've never seen a couple like
you guys call each other. Now, your name for Tommy is Lover. And
baby,
his name, Baby and Lover.
Baby and Lover.
Yeah.
And you never even call each other like Pam and Tommy.
No,
it's Baby and Lover.
I rarely call him Tommy, no.
It's Baby and Lover. And the whole tape, Baby and Lover. And I said, God, that's real love. That is so romantic. Do you know on the internet there's a tape of me and my wife?
Is there?
Did you hear about this?
No, I didn't.
I went through a similar experience. I'm going to play you some of it.
Really?
Because I know it's going to come out anyway and people are going to start selling it. These
are
three tapes. Yeah, I'm
no,
serious.
You're selling it.
I am not selling it. I'm embarrassed by it. Here's some of the tape.
Okay.
And I'm so disgusted because it sounds so different from your tape. I'll play you some of it. I don't care.
Okay.
All right, listen to this.
Baby, oh, I'm so horny for you. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. You're the sexiest woman on earth, baby.
Howard, who are you talking to?
Oh, Al, no one. I'm not talking to anyone.
All right, I gotta go.
Before you go, do me a favor. Get me some tissues, honey.
Oh.
That's
very romantic.
Isn't that romantic?
That's beautiful. It's unreal. Beautiful thing. You guys have been married for a long time now. So.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
You expect to get to this stage at some point?
Oh, wait. Just keep making tapes. Are you done with the video camera now? Will you not allow Tommy to tape you anymore?
It's just... Well, I wanted to... Can you imagine? I mean, I wanted to tape the birth of my son.
Don't.
The last thing I wanted to do when this came out, I was like, this is horrible.